So, this is just an update video from the one I made earlier on actually. So, as you can see, I'm in third person. I am an ODST, that's the Spartan player model for now. If I was doing really, it'd be a Brute Chieftain. So, there's been a few changes since earlier on, the first of which is the Pelican. Thanks to reject the shotgun, I've got the landing gear to work properly. It doesn't flip, and I've had to make it do a little bit of trickery to make it stay up. I will try and fix that properly though. You can still get into the side seats for the side, and like that. I'll try and fix the invisible barrier and the landing gear so that they didn't stop you from just jumping in. But until then, it is an okay solution to make the thing sit upright. I need to decrease the entry radius for the pilot seat because it interferes with the passenger seats. Obviously, when you get in, the landing gear raises, which is really cool, and I have my water poster, and then it drops down, like so. So that's a Pelican, and it's a group of Phantoms. I'm having a bit of trouble with them though, with getting the chin run to work. I might just make that into a seat for a gunner. I don't really know if any of this was synchronised over multiplayer enemies, so it might not be worth it, but who cares. I have also added in some bipeds into the forge menu. Now, they aren't forgeable like you would normally expect, and even though they are bipeds, they do have limitations. I think it was, so I'll come back from here, and as you can see it's got a rocket launcher in the back, but because it's a biped you can't actually switch to it. I don't know if there's a way to fix it. Because it's a biped being used as a vehicle even, you can't switch to it. You can't melee it either, because you're using it as a vehicle. However, you can jump, then you can fire, which is kind of cool, I suppose. It's the same for them all, obviously. I've got a few work on that on the Elite, but it just, you can't switch weapons and you can't really. I don't see if there's any workarounds, but I very much doubt it, if I'm being honest. Carrier, shits and giggles. I forgot to fix the camera shark for that and put it somewhere else, so it's just what it gives you as default, which is like really high for some weird reason. Obviously, Hunter. This can crouch for its start stance. Obviously, it can't melee either, which is quite sad because I like the Hunter's melee, but you know, it's working. Despite the fact that AI doesn't work on multiplayer, funnily enough, Flood Infection Forms do. And I think, if I'm remembering correctly, it's because of creatures and not strictly AI. But they do work, as does the Hunter. I've given the Hunter the fucking the anti-air race vertical. But yeah, that works. Miranda Keys as well. She's supposed to have a shotgun, but obviously doesn't work. But she does have a SMG, which is a weird perk. Get infinite ammo when you're driving a biped for whatever reason. I also have a Sentinel, which flies like a normal sentinel, but has to set in on being as its weapon. It's quite cool, to be honest. You know, it can fly. That's about it, to be honest. What's that? And then, last but not least, I have a... Technically, it's technically speaking, it's spawnable by a Fireforge. It's done for trickery, the same as the bipeds have been done. But it does spawn via Forge. It can't be manipulated through Forge or anything like that. And truth be told, if you're not careful, you can crash the game with this method. But if you try and spawn them too many and so on and so forth. But you know, it's fairly working scarab. And the actual turret works again. So there's that. I'm going to try and get the top turret to work either as its own independent vehicle or as part of, you know, the main driver. And let's say it's still about the crouch and that, you can still destroy it and such. But yeah, it's just a short update on my progress so far. The one big thing that kind of annoys me is if you're in a Pelican and you try and go into Forge, the editor, it will just flat out crash the game, and to be honest, I don't know why. But apart from that, things are coming along quite nicely, I would say. Had a few hurdles today already, but I've for the most part overcome them, and yeah, just a short update.